Now I call upon Mr. P.R. Lange, Assistant Vice President, Hindalco Industries, to deliver a presentation on Excellence by Design, the Hindalco Way. Please welcome Mr. Lange with a big round of applause.
Good afternoon, friends. Here I have come here for a presentation for this copper and aluminium. See, first of all, I would like to thank Mr. Mardia for his efforts for organizing this meet so that we can know each other and we can share our thoughts and what we are doing in India. As you are all aware, the topic of my presentation is Excellence by Design, the Hindalco Way. Hindalco, you know very well that this is a part of Aditya Birla Group, and we are the industry leader in aluminium and copper, and it is a metal flagship company of Aditya Birla Group. We are the world's largest aluminium rolling company and one of the biggest primary aluminium producer in Asia. Now the copper smelter is among largest single location copper smelter. We are located at Dahej in Gujarat. Hindalco, it operates, it is a non-ferrous metal powerhouse, aluminium comprising aluminium and copper. Now Hindalco operates 51 units in 11 countries and includes a workforce of 34,000 representing 15 different nationalities. Now in India, the first aluminium plant was commissioned in Renukoot in 1962. Other units are located at Muri in Jharkhand, Bellur in West Bengal, Kolur in Andhra Pradesh, Silvasa, Hirakud in Orissa, Alupuram in Kerala, Taloja, Belgaum in Karnataka, and copper only at Dahej, Gujarat. We have two R&D centers, mostly it is for aluminium. One is located at Belgaum and second one is at Taloja. Now this our Novelis is also part of Hindalco, Aditya Birla Group. It is headquartered in Atlanta, Georgia, and which operates 25 manufacturing facilities in 9 countries in four continents. We are having around 11,000 employees. Novelis is the world's largest rolled aluminium producer in terms of volume shipped and the largest purchaser of aluminium. We are the biggest recycler. Now Hindalco Almex operates first of its kind facility for India, high performance aluminium alloys, and it is located in Shendra, Aurangabad. Now this our excellence model, it is rest on our four strong pillars. Now this is powered by our Aditya Birla Group values. We are having 5 group values which we call integrity, commitment, passion, seamlessness and speed. Now it is driven by the fundamental tenets of our behavior, our code of conduct, governing principles and guiding policies. It is deployed through the execution framework which comprises essential processes and controls that will define every aspect of our daily operating procedures. Now it is reaffirmed continuously through measurement of all aspects of our output, result and performance. Thus, it ensures that total compliance and continuous improvement. Now, as Professor Murthy has also pointed out, this India is having used high quality bauxite, a very good quality bauxite, and it is having 5th largest country in the world. Now, per capita consumption is only 1.8 kg. Against 16.7 kg of China and 38.2 kg of Germany, and world average per capita consumption is 8 kg only. Now present production of aluminium and alumina in India is 2.01 and 4.78 million ton per annum. It is hoped that with the increase in country's GDP around 7 to 7.5% per annum in coming years, India's aluminium consumption will grow 5 to 6 times by 2022. Now this, as I have mentioned, this Hindalco's aluminium portfolio, it spreads across the globe. It entails value chain with the operation ranging from bauxite mining, alumina refining, aluminum smelting to downstream processes and products including rolling, extrusions, foil, recycling, along with captive power plants and coal mines. Novelis is the largest manufacturer of rolled aluminum products, that is 14% of the world's total. Now, resource sustainability of the minerals and metals is a key challenge for non-ferrous industry. We ensure that our holistic approach is sustainable and take into account stakeholders' interest. In India, our bauxite mines are located in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra, and Odisha, which provides raw material to our alumina refineries located at Belgaum in Karnataka, Muri in Jharkhand, Utkal in Odisha, and Ranukut in UP. Now, basically, I am from copper, and I am fortunate enough to be associated with the copper since last 32 years. India is among top 10 major copper producers globally. Its present consumption is around 600 KT of refined copper. India ranks fifth in smelter and sixth in refined copper production in the globe. Typically, over 44% demand is from wire and cable sector, 22% from winding wire, 16% from strips and transformers, 9% from automobile, and balance 13% from others. Now, with that, our total urbanization and all these things, our growth, it will grow further. India's copper market has a significant potential for the growth. Indian economy is the fourth largest of the world after US, China, and Japan. With growing urban population, India is expected to see an increase in demand for the copper, and it will come mainly from the construction industry. Now, plans for heavy investment in railways for next 5 years will result into increased copper consumption. Now, India increase in copper in architectural use like interior and exterior of wall cladding, radio frequency shielding, and antimicrobial indoor products such as handrails, bathroom fixtures, and countertops, it will further increase India's copper consumption. Now, about this Birla Copper Dahej. Now, this our Dahej in India, we are located, it is a single location copper plant. We are located at Dahej, which is 350 kilometers from Mumbai and 50 kilometers from National Highway number 8. We are having around located, this area is total around 311 hectares, having 23 fully integrated and interdependent plant in the same location. We are catering to the five industry segments and 15 different technologies we have absorbed. Now, as far as logistics is concerned, we are handling 5 million ton of material per annum, around 350 trucks per day and 150 ships per year, because we are having our own captive jetty. Now, this global supply chain, we are exporting to 15 different countries, and our raw materials we are outsourcing from 10 countries. We have 2 mines in Australia, our own mines, and balance copper we get it from Indonesia, Chile, Canada, and these mines I already explained to you. Now, this is about our total capacity. This copper smelting capacity is 500,000 ton. Refinery is same thing, 500,000 ton. We have continuous cast rod plant, 1.6 lakh ton per annum. Sulfuric acid, 17.64 ton. Now, this you will be surprised. See that we are here for the non-ferrous industry. In addition to that, what I have explained, we are also in the fertilizer sector, because you will appreciate that we are producing around 17.6 lakh ton sulfuric acid per annum. And our acid requirement, suppose there is no surety about its captive consumption, then we have to stop our smelter, because we cannot allow our smelter to run without operating sulfuric acid plant. So, to ensure that we have a captive consumption of this sulfuric acid, we have put that fertilizer plant So we are producing around 1.8 lakh ton per annum phosphoric acid, and this phosphoric acid we are using it for making diammonium phosphate. So around 400,000 ton diammonium phosphate we are producing. This raw material means copper concentrate, it contains gold and silver in very low contents, means parts per million. So we are recovering this gold and silver also. So around 15 ton per annum gold, we have the capacity of 15 ton per annum gold and 150 ton per annum silver. But gold and silver production mainly depends on the impurity content in our raw material. Suppose if in our raw material gold is high, so production will be high. If it is content is low, then production will be low. We have captive power plant, 135 megawatt. Oxygen plant, which is required for our smelter. So 2200 ton per day, we have oxygen plant. And jetty, 4.5 million ton cargo we are handling from our jetty. LME grade A producer. We have the phosphoric acid, sulfuric acid is also merchant grade. Gold and silver, it is 24 karat pure gold we are producing. And this fertilizers. Now, this what we did. See, we have selected the best available technology across the globe. For smelter, we used technology from Outokumpu, Finland, Mitsubishi, Japan. Oxygen plant, we have that, I think, three technologies. One is Praxair, Air Liquide, France, BOC, UK. Because as we expanded, so we have added this utilities. Refinery, it is from Mount Isa, Australia. Precious metal plant, again it is from Outokumpu Engineering, Finland. CC rod plant, it is from Southwire, USA. Sulfuric acid, Monsanto, USA. Phosphoric acid plant, it is diadic process from SNC Levlin. Fertilizer, it is from Incro, Spain. Pipe reactor, it is from Krupp, Germany, and jetty is Ho. So the main purpose is to that the technology should be environment friendly, and it's at the same time it should be a low energy intensive. Now flash smelting, see, when we are getting that copper concentrate which is around 27 to 32% copper, so we get copper mate which is having around 62% copper, then it is goes to converter, so we get blister copper which is having 98 to 99% purity. Now this blister copper is further refined to anode copper, so we get anode copper that is 99.6% purity. This is the anode casting, and after that this is electro refined to get electrolytic copper. Now this is our view of sulfuric acid plant, double conversion, double absorption technology. Central side it is phosphoric acid plant, and that this is DAP. Now this copper production, this is this our total production in India, it is around 4% of the world production. So now it is expected to grow, because if whatever projected figure I have taken, it is only for up to 2019. So same figure, if we grow further in India, whether it is Sterlite or Hindustan Copper or Birla Copper, so this figure will change it again. And I am confident again there will be a tremendous growth in the copper industry. Now, this is the slide. We are, before 10 years, we were deficit in copper. We were importing copper from other countries. Now we are surplus in copper. We are exporting to other country. Because, see, I'll show you that our total production figure. Say last year, this the production figure in India was 780 kiloton. And our total consumption was 540 kiloton. So we were having 240 ton balance, means export. We have exported to other countries. It is total for the Sterlite and Hindalco. Now in some part, it is excess, some part it was a deficit. India we were having surplus copper, in that North America that it was a this copper consumption was very high in comparison to their production. Now this is the product wise analysis, as I already mentioned, because this total copper, about 87% of our production, it is converted into copper rod, which is especially required for that strip and transformer, wire and cable, winding wire, then automobile and balances others. That is only 13% to others, means this housing sector. Now this is about total industry's performance. See, agriculture sector, industry, construction and services. Now there is a tremendous growth in this industry and services sector, and India's GDP is expected to grow around 7 to 7.5% post FY15. And this manufacturing and industry sector, it got the benefit from low commodity and oil prices. As a global growth is expected to increase, now India's manufacturing will further boost from the rising exports, and that copper will also, copper or all non-ferrous metal will get the benefit of that. Now this is about the typical case of that our copper consumption. Now as you know, this per capita copper consumption in India, it is only 0.41 kg. It is expected in by 15 it will be 0.42, and by 2016 it will be 0.44 kg per capita consumption. Against this, China is, it is 5.4 kg, USA is 10, Japan is 11, and world average is 2.8 kg. Now this growth, of course, this due to that slowdown in China, there was a impact in that our industrial sector. But even then, this copper is at a minimum price since last five and a half years. Now the prices is lowest in last five and a half years. Now even then, this, we see the growth of copper industry by 3.1% in the coming years. Now this is about total the market share. Birla Copper is still at almost at par. Hindustan Copper is around 3% and imports is 33%. Now this import, it is a big threat for our country. I'll show you. Now this, what is the favorable conditions? Now change in global uses, it will further increase in copper consumption or copper export. Now industrial development in India, it is expecting around 6% growth in copper industry in next 10 years. And it will be third largest consumer after China and USA. Now domestic increase in construction, power, telecommunication and automobile sector, this will also help for the export and consumption of the per capita consumption of copper in India. Making of alloys, now promotion of coppers in architectural uses like wall cladding and its antimicrobial properties. Now such kind of seminar gives us opportunity for the users, and it will be a brainstorming that how we can increase the this copper production in India and become a good leading exporter in the country. Now the challenges, the biggest challenges which is non-ferrous industry is facing. Now of course we are blessed in terms of bauxite, but in terms of copper, now availability of good quality raw material, it is a big problem for India's, because see, nowadays we are not getting good quality raw material. Now this grade copper concentrate, copper grade is depleting. Say every time we are getting, say if we compare before five years, the mines, any mines in Chile which was supplying around 35-36% copper, now it has come down to 28-29%. Now weak demand from the China at present, declining average grade, now significant threat of import of value-added product. Now this is also our government has to take that in morning also we have discussed. Now we are getting lot of copper, and that too from countries like Malaysia, Indonesia, and it has posed a big challenge to our Indian manufacturer. Because see, what they are doing, they are supplying that copper wire. They may be getting duty advantage. Our customer is also getting at low price and at value-added products. So this is why they are buying for that. Now, inadequate exploration, because of course in India our copper ore is a very low quality grade, and we have not developed so far any new mines. Now, discoveries of high grade deposits becoming less frequent. It is not in India but across the globe. We are not getting a good mines where we are having a good deposits of the copper. Now, the Hindalco, now we are committed to working with our stakeholders to realize social, environmental and economic benefits for the communities around the world. We achieve this by using our technological skill in product design, innovation, as well as our long-term partnership to integrate sustainability into all aspects of our business. And I hope that because see now this is a good forum that now primary or secondary producers, it may be a primary or secondary producer, but our vision is 2022. So we all should aim so that our that country's growth, our GDP again goes to 7.58%, and I am confident that we will surpass this China. Thank you.